Whitestones and Larry Rawson ready for the women's 100 meters. And that is Gwen Torrence, who won a bronze medal at this event at the Olympic Games in Atlanta and anchored the successful 4x100 relay. And the Olympic champion, the last two Olympics, Gail Devers, won both of those gold medals in a very close photo finish over this woman, Merline Otte, the 36-year-old queen of sprinting, finally won a silver medal instead of a bronze medal.
Right, what's interesting, I went back and checked the records on Swiss timing, and this woman, Merline Otte, the woman next to her, Gail Devers, got out of the blocks exactly in the same time, to a thousandth of a second, and at the finish line, they were separated by about 1.5 inches. And they had the same time to a hundredth. It took them going to the thousands to separate the two, and they get out of the blocks. It was plus 166 out of a thousand. Exactly, it was amazing.
It was incredible how close that those races were, as well as the finish in Stuttgart at the World Championships in 1993. A great field here, as you see Gail Devers' signature nails, and she has her game face on here. Merline Otte would love to get an opportunity to redeem herself from Atlanta.
Quickly, let's go over what may happen here. Usually, Devers is the best explosive starter at 5'3", and she will be in lane 5 in the middle of the track. She gets out well. Otte gains over the last 50 or 60 meters. Let's see if that happens. There is no friendship between these two women you see on camera right now. Torrence gets out well, but tries not to give more than one step to Devers, and she closes well also.
Fail.
Good reaction for Gwen Torrence as she drifts into Devers' lane almost. It is Devers at this point with Torrence on her left. It is going to be Torrence, Devers, and Otte. But at the finish, it's very close between Gwen Torrence and Merline Otte. And what's important about that is Merline Otte won the 100 meters in Oslo, so she has one leg up on the gold. She would love to be able to win here to keep the possibility of winning that gold alive.
The way these women are acting, I'm not sure they really feel who won. The press is surrounding two of the runners, not one. It is Devers, usual, explosive start. Look at the edge. She's got a foot or two, certainly on Torrence. Torrence is beginning to gain better. She's a better starter than Otte. Now watch Otte start to close here. Just as we talk, look at the size of the strides as they both close in on Devers. And the question is, did Otte get to the finish line before Gwen Torrence? There's the answer, it's yes. It is Otte who is the winner.
So Merline Otte has two wins in a row in the Golden Four, so she stays eligible for the gold at the end of the season. And what a great come from behind for the 36-year-old Jamaican sprinter. And the results of that great 100 meters, Merline Otte of Jamaica, 10.95, Gwen Torrence, 10.96, and Gail Devers fading back to third in 11 flat.
I don't know how she does it at age 36 years of age. Linford Christie's a grandfather, but your heritage down there, you keep, continue to provide inspiration to your country of Jamaica. Why do they produce such great sprinters?
I think we're born naturally gifted. There's something in the... You know, if you trace back the history, most kids do a lot of walking, they work hard. I remember from when I started to walk to school and to run everywhere because I don't want to be late to school because we didn't have the school bus. So we are always in good condition from 4 or 5 years old when we start school.